Now let me welcome our first guest, Mounia El Hilali, IKEA Country Retail Manager and Chief Sustainability Officer for the region Czech Republic, Hungary and Slovakia. Hello, Mounia.
Hello, are good morning.
Hello.
Good morning.
Mounia, please share with us what does diversity mean exactly to you and why it's important for IKEA?
Very good. So good morning, everyone. I'm very pleased to be with all of you again and feel so much energy about the topic. So I would like to start by sharing why diversity matters to me first as a person. And I would like to say that I have been very privileged and had the opportunity to grow in a diverse family myself, and to be also able to travel and work in many different countries during my young period, but also when after my study and also in my working life. And this diverse experience across the world, living both in South America, in Spain, in Morocco, in France, is really giving me the opportunity to understand different culture and different background and different differences in culture and embrace them. And I would like to say that if you believe that you need that, you need to travel, you need to meet different cultures and countries to embrace diversity in your leadership, well, I would like to ask you to think twice, because I do believe that we don't need that to be able to really embrace the diversity and inclusion. And being fair and equal, how do we treat people around us? And being a good leader, to me, as first, is really much about understanding, being curious about different people and differences, and have enough balance between empathy and compassion to really be able to embrace the diversity in your leadership every day. And then I would like also to share that I do brief diversity in my everyday. Actually, my direct team, the management team member for the Czech, Hungary and Slovakia team in IKEA is really much diverse. My team is really half and half, actually. I have half men and half women. We manage also to have a good representation. Half is from the Czech Republic, and the other half come from Italy, Spain, China, Greek, France. So I can tell you that our meeting are very spicy, and the discussion are very interesting. I have the possibility to really embrace different point of view, different ideas, opinion. And as we said, we positively have good fights, but the end result for the business is extremely good. So I would definitely recommend also that working with different nationalities, backgrounds, and having a good gender balance is crucial also for the business. Then also let me share with you gender equality matters for IKEA and where are we today? We are fortunate to be an extremely loved company. And my first belief is because we are extremely humanistic, value-driven company. And we are committed to go all in diversity and inclusion because equality is at really at the heart of the human right. And I think you started by saying it in your introduction. It's not a luxury, it's a human right. Then how do we do that? I would like also to share with you, how do we create a diverse and inclusive environment at IKEA, where we believe it's good for the coworker, it's good for the customer, there, it's good for the business. And the way we do it, I've been talking about it already last year, and I will be very consistent and stick to it. As first, it's important to have quota and KPI and measure them. So we have goals in IKEA where we go for 50% gender equality, and we measure ourselves in that, which means that having facts and being transparent with the fact, but also following up on our commitment is extremely important. And the 50-50 is not an average. 50-50 is about understanding that we need to give equal opportunity to men and women in all the level of the organization. That's why it's important to go in depth and in the detail to secure that we give equal opportunity. Giving equal opportunity bridge into the fact that we also measure ourselves into zero gap payment between men and women in all the level. And I'm extremely proud of my team, the work they have been doing, looking at each and every employee in our organization, and we are 4,000 plus, to make sure that each and every IPE, salary level, men and women, we do not make any difference in the salaries. And it's a detailed work, but it's worth to invest time into it. And with the surprise that we still sometimes find some failure in the process that we readdress and secure that we close the gap. So measuring ourselves is extremely important. Dedicating the right process for it is extremely important, and securing that at the end of the day, we do give equal opportunity to men and women, but also we secure a good salary level in all the levels. And we go beyond that. For us, working with equality, diversity, inclusion, it's also looking at vulnerable groups. And here I'm extremely proud of the initiative we have launched together with my team, taking care of women victims of domestic abuse. And there is still a lot to do. We have had started the journey together with NGOs, association, but also together with the government to really make a change and make a positive change in the society. You can imagine, and you can see it in the numbers, that many women are affected by domestic violence still. And one of the elements we discover in digging deeper in the fact is that we also put women in a vulnerable place when there is a gap in income. And I think this is, and we believe in IKEA, this is unacceptable. So how can we also secure better income for women to not put them in even more vulnerable situation in this topic as well? So I think it's what I want to say now is looking at equality, gender equality, it's go beyond the salary. We need to have a look at the 360 degree and secure that there we really want to make an equal world, equal society for both men and women.
Okay. Mounia, I saw this, the video spot in what you did in domestic violence, and it's just brilliant. So thank you very much for it. And I have a question. I heard that you did some research. So how would you evaluate the gender equality at household based on your expertise and data you have?
Yes, thank you very much for your question. And at the same time, I would like to highlight that whatever we do, something that looks like a campaign behind it's, the intention is not to have only a campaign for the campaign, but behind the campaign, there is an initiative with a lot of people working on clear assignment, clear action plan, and also clear goal that we want to achieve. So I'm very happy that this has resonated into many people, and we had had a lot of positive returns. But everything started from analyzing data and looking what's going on in the market with this topic. And so here, I would like to say it's easy to say that we don't live in a gender equality society. But with the facts we have, I would like also to share with you what was the interesting result that we found when we conducted this study about gender equality. So on average, 85% of people in our region think that gender equality is important. So that's a first positive step, that most of the people believe that this is something important and we need to work on it. then equality is easier to find at home than at the workplace. And at work, there is a sharp difference in evaluating equality between men and women. In Czech Republic, only 39% of women are satisfied with gender equality at work. And more than 61% of women agree with the fact that women are held back because they do more housework than men. In comparison with 29% of men, similar results couldn't be seen regarding the child care. So the fair home is a happier home, and 65% of Czechs says that a fair distribution of domestic work contributes to a happier partnership. So at least in this, we can have already a handshake and an agreement. Looking only at couples where both partners work, women spend almost 1 hour more with housework a day than a man, which when you put it all together, it's 1 day per week. So guys, what do you do during this free time? In 1 in 10 households are men completely responsible for domestic work. Only a third of households, partners, share housework. And then we also realized during the study that the stereotypes in the home are still valid regarding distribution of household duties, because we can believe this belongs to the past, but women still are cook, iron, clean, and so on. And men are answering the study saying, well, we normally go for the garbage or cleaning the car and so on. So it's no surprise that this division of domestic work has been also confirmed by the research. So we have based also our campaign and game to engage the many into opening the dialogue on how can we make sure also that at home we can have a more equal time split between the household work. So I must say that looking at the data, there is a confirmation and a good willingness to move on the positive side, but there is also a confirmation that there is still quite some work to do in that one.
IKEA is definitely a leader in diversity. What would you suggest to other companies and other leaders who are willing to support gender equality in their companies, but let's say they are struggling at the moment? What is the key to focus on?
Yeah, you know, now I will repeat probably the word data too many times, but I do believe that, you know, talking about fact is also securing that we make a movement in action. But according to the Gender Equality Index for 2020, Czech Republic has fallen significantly over the last 10 years. So which means that the trend is also not improving. And so, you know, I would like to sit here with you together all next year and see a true movement in the data, because we cannot sit every year talking about the topic and not seeing any movement. And we should be part of this movement. We are the one who can make a difference here. And sadly also we see that within the Europe, and of course for us, we are looking at Czech Republic, Slovakia and Hungary, and unfortunately the three countries that are in the bottom of the list of the Europe. So it's a real question to make, how do we make the movement? How do we come back into the top of the list? How can we learn also from other countries? How can we apply them? How can we shift that so we leave a better society to the generation to come? I am a mother of three kids, and it starts also by sharing with them, educating them, and showing them that this is not the right image we want to give them to move to the generation to come. So let me answer to your question in a way that let's act, let's start by us, let's act in our perimeter of influence. So whomever sits in the virtual room, ask yourself, what can I do myself within my perimeter of influence? Because we all can make a difference in our close environment and together make a bigger shift into that. let's set realistic goals and let's move them quickly. Where would you like to see Czech Republic next year and the year after and the year after? So we can really build on a positive trend and movement. It would be super easy to use the COVID as an excuse and say, you know what, we have been busy with the COVID. But let me tell you that let's take the COVID as an opportunity to make the change, a positive change in the society. So let's also build on that to say, how should look like post-COVID? So how do we want to see the new gender equality look like in our companies, in our home, in the society, so we can really create the change in the totality? I believe we can do. Some countries has managed to go through. I see the willingness in the country. I see amazing people sitting today in this virtual conference and during the week, been following all the amazing discussion. I think let's be bold. Let's put clear KPI, but let's walk the talk. Let's make a difference here. And let's all do that together, because I believe that together we are stronger. Thank you.
Mounia, we have a direct question from Christina. Mounia, how can women realize that they are paid less? Many times salaries or remuneration for freelance projects are not communicated openly. What would you recommend to women who wonder if they could be paid less? How can they verify that?
Yeah, you have said a key word in your questions and I really like it. You said openly. I think it starts by giving transparency. And we also, you know, to be honest, I'm operating in an international company in many different countries. And when I arrived also in the Czech, Hungary and Slovakia organization, I also realized that transparency was not at its best. And I decided to put it at its best. So any coworker can have a transparent view on the salary range. If I'm a cashier, this is the salary range. Where do I sit in the salary range? Why? Ask the question to your leader. They have the responsibility obligation to give the transparency and explain you your salary level. There is no place for discrimination. The discrimination is a violence of human rights. And I call it discrimination. So let's start by don't be afraid to ask the question. Don't be afraid to assess your situation and to see where do you sit in the band of your scope of responsibility and ask the question why. And if you didn't get the right answer, ask again why. And if nobody give you the right, keep on asking and searching. There will be someone who give you the right answer. So transparency for me is key. Responsibility of your leader is key, of the HR department is important. Don't be afraid. This is not a shame. This is your right.
Thank you. And if I can read a comment from our chat, Lenka Simerska, thank you for your example. And we have done another question. What can I do? I influence just 5 people around me.
You know, I believe that everyone matters. So it's not a matter of saying, oh, you know, if you can influence only one person's life, it's one life. And then by doing that, you are leading by example. I think this is super important. And never forget that by doing that, you also inspire others to do more. It's, you know, the snowball effect. I believe in that. I really started, I started when I was a student. I was a cashier in a sports shop. And I, even when I was the cashier, I believe I could influence, I could do something. And slowly you scope become bigger because you're heard. And we are here, and I love your introduction by saying, we want people to be heard. We want women to be heard. You are heard. So make sure that you raise your voice and make sure that even one person can, this person will also influence another person that will influence another person. So my tip to you, and I did my journey into that, that every little step you do, if you think it's, you know, I'm too little, it doesn't matter, but there is no small steps. There is just steps. So let's do the steps together, and together we amplify and get stronger and bigger.
Mounia, I have a question to you. What kind of advice should we give to our kids?
Regarding
this topic.
Yes, absolutely. I think at least if I can refer to how I do it at home, you know, the education is not about making statements and then doing something different. You know, if my husband is saying to my kids, oh, you know, it's important to, you know, to share, but then they see their father lying on the sofa, then it doesn't work. So I think it's start by also leading by example and showing to them that this is how good should look like, and then expressing how good should look like. So we try to do really much that with our kids. We also are working very much on the differences. So when they come back from school and say, oh, you know, we have this person and she come from Japan and she told me. And so we embrace the discussion in a very positive way. Oh, but this is very interesting. And how can you express your feeling about it? And you see how nice it is to discover different people and different culture. So it's important to have an open dialogue, to be transparent about it, because, you know, we know also that the generation before, and I can also refer to my parents, and my mother was not very open in dialogue, but I understood that talking about the things, addressing the topics, putting names and description about it, it's very important. So I would say dialogue, transparency, leading by example, it's very important.
And what is or who is the person who influenced you the most in this topic, in this area?
You know, I think if I come back to your previous question, I had amazing 2 to 3 women that give me the chance to raise my voice once. And I didn't know if I could dare to do that and if I could do that. And I did it, and I realized that while doing it, they empowered me. And when they empowered me, I felt that, oh, that works. And so I can empower also. So then when you feel, you see that you empower people around you, that is really creating this positive spiral. And that suddenly you think, oh my God, we have make a change. We impact here. It works. So let's go for it. So now I'm become a true believer that by empowering, by raising the voice, by using all the young generation that are in the streets, sharing their fault, their concern, we have the responsibility, but also the privilege, and more if we are in a leadership role, to use it, to empower these people to raise their voice and to be heard, to also put government, other entities, in front of their responsibilities, that this is how we make good and positive change in the society, in the citizen, in the society.
Well, yeah, I would like to thank you for your inspirational speech. If you can, yes.
Yeah, clapping. Yeah,
thank you very much.
If you can stay with us for a while and maybe answer some question on our chat, it will be great.
My pleasure.
So again, thank you very, very, very much for your
thank
words
you very
and
much.
For your work.
Thank you. Thank you for listening.
Mounia El Hilali, IKEA Country Retail Manager and Chief Sustainability for the region Czech Republic, Hungary and Slovakia was our guest. Thank you.
Thank you.